Hi, and welcome to another Chem 1A lecture video with Professor Brooks. This time we'll be talking about different ways to represent chemicals. The learning objectives that you want to build upon are how to identify substances when shown in various representations, including their molecular and ionic formula, the structural formula, space-filling models, and ball-and-stick models. There are three major ways in which chemists like to depict matter. And each has its purpose and utility. The first is the macroscopic domain, which is the domain that we are most familiar with in everyday life as we're looking at the objects as we perceive them with our human sight and touch. The second is referred to as the microscopic domain, but would be better referred to as the molecular domain, as it is a view of looking at the atomic level of matter, which is not readily visualized under a standard microscope. Thirdly, we have the symbolic domain. This domain uses the specialized language that is used to represent components of the macroscopic and microscopic domains using chemical symbols. It's very useful in labeling the content of chemical compounds and in describing reactions. You'll see a lot more information about the symbolic form of representation when we get to our unit on chemical compounds. Therefore, this video is going to focus more on the molecular or microscopic domain. So focusing back in on water, its symbolic representation should be very familiar to you as H2O. This tells us the relative number of atoms that make up one molecule, that there is two hydrogen atoms and one oxygen atom in each water molecule. However, it doesn't really tell us how those atoms are arranged. Another way of depicting water would be through its structural formula. We'll be covering this when we look more closely at bonding and Lewis structures. But what this next image shows you is that the two hydrogen atoms are flanking the oxygen atom, with oxygen in the center and a single chemical bond reaching to each hydrogen atom. This lets us understand more about the geometry and nature of the water molecule. However, it is still rather symbolic in that it is using the chemical symbol H for hydrogen and O for oxygen. Another way of representing water is using a ball and stick structure shown here. Ball and stick structures may or may not have the chemical symbols also on the spheres representing the elements of each atom, but they generally are using color to represent common elements. This shows a simplified view of the bonding within the molecule. A more accurate depiction would be the space-filling model. Here we see the same color convention used as within the ball and stick model, but the symbols have been removed. And instead of using a stick to represent the covalent bonds for between oxygen and hydrogen, we actually see the spheres of oxygen and hydrogen overlapping. The sphere is used to represent the electron cloud surrounding the nucleus of the atom. And it is understood that in covalent bonding, the electron clouds merge such that electrons can be shared between atoms. So here are four ways in which we can represent water. Let's look at a more complex example to see how, again, these different depictions can be useful in describing a piece of matter. Our next example is caffeine, which has a symbolic formula of C8H10N4O2. Now, there are many ways in which these elements could be connected to create a molecule. And so when we're dealing with these large molecules, the structural formula becomes increasingly important to understand the chemistry of the molecule. In the center, we see the ball and stick model. Here, removing the elemental symbols and just using color to illustrate the types of atoms involved. In general, when you see a ball and stick model, you can expect that any gray or black sphere is representing a carbon atom, while red represents oxygen, blue represents nitrogen, and white represents hydrogen. This common color scheme becomes increasingly important as you look into organic chemistry, where these are the four most common elements found in molecules. Again, we can see our space-filling model on the right, showing the overlapping electron orbitals of the caffeine model. This space-filling image is very interesting in that it shows that caffeine is actually a somewhat solid molecule, whereas the ball and stick appears that a piece of matter could go through the center of this ring. You can see in the space-filling model that area is actually filled with electrons of the atoms around the ring. You can now take a moment to test your understanding of these concepts by going through these four examples. For each example, jot down which type of representation it is giving you of the molecule. Is it a structural formula, a ball and stick formula, or a space-filling model? Next, try to write out the symbolic representation for each of the molecules. Once that's done, you're on your way to understanding the different representations of molecules in chemistry.